All right, so to finish this off, I'm going to show you just the last steps. In the two previous videos, I showed you how to get to this point. And so from that point to this point, I added white, and then I added some more red. So now what I'm going to do is add some more black. And it helps to have a sheet of paper to practice on, so you know if how strong how much paint that you have on your sponge. That is helpful. If you get too much, just dab it around. Now, if you press too hard with this type of synthetic sponge, your fingerprints will show through it, so that's also something just to be aware of. At this point, what's going to work really well and look really nice with the layering is just to lightly dab the sponge down. That's working the best. Because again, you're just trying to create depth, you're trying to create visual interest and fill up the space so that you don't have so much white negative space. So you're going to do this all the way around. And each time, like I said in the other videos, you do want to let it dry. You're going to have the best result when you let it dry completely. And I would recommend using a dry sponge. This sponge is not as dry as it could be. You're going to have a better effect. You're going to have more of a crisp, clean sponge effect when you do that. And then we're going to do, the last one we're going to do is yellow, and that'll really make it pop a lot more. And again, as I stated earlier, you have to be careful because it can start getting really, really muddy fast. And that's why I start off with the primary colors. So then we'll add some yellow. Get the black off my hands. And for this, I really want to practice on paper because I don't want it to be too strong. So I'll get my sponge full of paint. And just like with the last one, the last demonstrations for this, you start in the center. I'm just going to lightly do this. At this point, we're trying to create a unified background. So that is why we're spreading the colors throughout. And we have a focal point more in the center. You could do the focal point off to the side. You could have more than one focal point. Doesn't necessarily have to look this way. And if you feel like this is too bright and it's competing with the foreground too much, you can push it back down with white like I did. If you watch the dry brush method video, it shows you how to do that. You can do that. And it will push all of this into the background and give you a nice rich background without it competing with the foreground. And I'm looking at this and I'm feeling like it needs more yellow, so that it pops more. And of course you can choose a different colors to do this with. And you can see if the yellow overlaps the black too much, it starts looking green. So that's something to be aware of too. So once you get paint on your sponge, you always want to start where you want it to be the strongest and then work your way out that way. You know, so I want just a little bit to come out here. And so I don't want a lot on the sponge, and so that's why I start in the center. And again, this is to create unity in the piece, because the background, again, is the background. It's not necessarily supposed to keep your interest, it's supposed to balance out the foreground. So that is one way to create a background to fill up negative space for your piece.